ladies. What do you like to do? Sit back and relax and watch Girl Talk 2. Conversations with ladies. What you like to do? Sit back and relax and watch Girl Talk 2. Conversations with Sha going through the roof. Each and every Sunday, tell a friend and tell a friend. Tune in at 8 p.m. Empower women. Doing better is the motto. Instagram we follow. Cause girls run the world. We let our minds lead the way. The future is bright. We should have Girl Talk every night. Girls run the world. We let our minds lead the way. The future is bright. We should have Girl Talk every night. Girls run the world. We let our minds lead the way. The future is bright. We should have Girl Talk every night. Girl Talk. Ladies. Watch Girl Talk 2. Conversations with Sha going through the roof. Each and every Sunday, tell a friend and tell a friend. Tune in at 8 p.m. Empower women. Doing better is the motto. Instagram we follow. Cause girls run the world. We let our minds lead the way. The future is bright. We should have Girl Talk every night.
What up, what up, what up? Yo, I'm doing both at one time. That's mad funny. Hey. What up? How we doing? How we doing? You know what it is. It's Sunday. It's Sunday. We out here. It's 4th of July. I know a lot of people at cookouts and stuff like that. Shout out to y'all. Everybody be safe with these fireworks. And we don't want to hit them for like a year going straight. It's WVOX. Girl Talk. You already know what it is. The voice of the people. What up, Selena? This is my first time Selena's not here at the radio station with me, right? So I'm nervous. But what up, what up, what up? Shout out to everybody. House 4th of July going. Everybody's out. I was out, but I had to come to work. Everybody's like, Shanice, where you going? I'm like, I'll be back. I'll be back, but right now I got to go do what I got to do. It's nice out. Yesterday was a little rainy and stuff. We was a little scared. It was a little shaky, but ain't no rain. So we here. What up, Jay? We got my man Jay here, though. You already know. We working, like. Everybody don't get to have fun on 4th of July, you know? Who celebrated Juneteenth? Is people that, like, if you celebrated Juneteenth, are you not celebrating 4th of July? Or, like, what's going down? Are we doing both now? Because that's just more money. Like, think about it. If we doing both, they getting us. Like, you better just do one because they still coming up no matter. Right, you got to celebrate Juneteenth. It's Jay's birthday, so you still got to do 4th of July, too. Right, see? But there's people doing both. Like, so the people is getting us and getting that money. Like, oh, they want to celebrate two holidays in, like, the same, almost the same, but June, July. But what up, what up, what up? How we feeling? I was driving here. Shout out to all my radio listeners. Shout out to y'all. I hate that I can't see y'all. Maybe because I started off with Girl Talk and I've always been live and talking to people and seeing the people talk back. And, you know, I can't see y'all on the radio. But, hey, how y'all doing? Y'all can always call in. You know, I'm on Girl Talk, G-U-R-R-L Talk. If you ever want to, you know, call in, if you got Instagram, if you got YouTube. I know everybody don't have an Instagram. Some people got YouTube. But if you ever want to see how the show is, what we do, you know, see me doing my thing and not just hear me, Girl Talk, follow. Shout out to everybody. I wrote down a note, right? I wrote down some notes driving here. I didn't know what I was going to talk about. I'm like, I'm just going to freestyle it. It's a Freestyle Friday. That's it. Talk about your 20s. Like, 20s, I had so much fun. Like, I was thinking driving here, like, sometimes people, you know, you grow up, you mature, you grow up and stuff like that, and you forget who you were, like, in your 20s, you know, when you probably was carefree. What up, Chris? When you probably was carefree, when you was just, like, doing whatever. And now, you know, we're maturing. People want to start businesses. People getting their money up. People buying houses. And, like, you start to act like you never was where you were. Like, I just always want to remember my 20s. Like, the 20s to me, I mean, I wasn't like, you know, I wasn't this person, right? But 20s was mad fun. Like, I had so much fun. I did a lot of dumb stuff, but I guess that makes you who you are now. Like, right. But, you know, some people act like they don't or didn't go through that stage or... Right. Right. Those are your learning years. And they're great years. And I know people see me like, oh, Shani's doing her thing. But, yeah. Like, I remember what we was doing, you know? I'll never forget. And I just don't want nobody to forget that either, you know? To start looking down on people like, oh, she ain't... And people grow at different times. Like, you know, just because you're this mature now doesn't mean I have to be. Like, like, you know, you could tell a person, you could guide a person, but you got to let... My string is stuck. Sorry. You got to let people go through their stuff. I don't know where that came from. What up? How y'all doing out there? WVOX 1460 AM, the voice of the people. We in the building. Happy 4th of July. It's my baby nephew Cash's birthday. Shout out to Cash. He turned 2 years old today. That's my boo. Shout out to all the cancers. God. Let's not even talk about cancers. Because. Woo. That. All in their feelings. All emotional. Boys and girls. My sister's a cancer. Like my nephews are cancers. I'm like, oh no. But shout out to all of y'all. Shout out to the cancer. Shout out to my baby Cash. Happy 2 birthday. The best birthday to have. Like, how's your birthday on 4th of July? Like, you always know it's going to be a party. It's going to be a turnout. It's going to be a cookout. You're going to get some free food somewhere. Just bring your cake. That's it. What up, energy? What up? Hey, y'all listening. Girl talk. I was out. I'm not going to lie. We was out to cookout having a good time. Like, I was having a good time, and I'm like, I gotta go. So, shout out to everybody that's still there. Shout out to everybody at our little cookout we having in our backyard. Yeah, it's very emotional. Shout out to everybody in the backyard. Shout out to Cortland Street. Shout out to Mount Vernon. I don't know if I ever shout out, like, where I'm from. But shout out to Mount Vernon. Shout out to the West Side, Cortland First Street. You already know what it is. That's where I grew up at. I've lived in the same place, like, from when I was born to, like, 27 or whatever, until I moved out on my own. I lived in the same place, like, my whole life. Everybody in the building lived there. The other day, I posted a picture. The lady been living there. My upstairs neighbor been living there for 50 years, and my mother has been living there for, like, 35 years. Like... Everybody in that building. So shout out to that building. I could always go get me some sugar, some milk, some breakfast. Go upstairs, Cheryl cook breakfast. Shout out to everybody. You know, living in the building. You ain't know nothing else. So I never wanted to live in a house. I love having neighbors. I love going upstairs in the same building, downstairs, and not having to get in the car or something like that. Yes, it was very litty. The drinks was pouring. So we here. I'm here. I wrote down these notes. So where do y'all, like, where's your thinking place at? If somebody could call in or talk to me. Like, every time I'm in my car, I think. Like, my car is my thinking spot or the shower. Really? Yes. Yes. I sing in my car. I'm talking to Jay. I'm talking to my man right here. Y'all can't see him. But yes, I sing most. I think I am. But I'm coming in here today. Just now, I had the music blast. I was like, oh, let me turn the music down. Like, I had the music blasting. I'm singing. Like, I'm lit. Like, yeah, I'm about to go to the radio station. Like, I still got to do my thing. What Sasha said, the shower early in the morning, laying in the bed. Okay. Mine is definitely my car and my shower. Like, I think all my ideas come from those two places. No, like, yeah, like, not yet. Yeah, walks do help, but my car is like fast. So it's like, oh, why didn't I think of that? Like, you know what I mean? It's like, as soon as I step out, it's like, let me get back in my car real quick. So sometimes I'll just let me get back in my car. Sometimes I would just drive because I know I'll find the answer. I know my safe spot. Right. You know? Right. Like, I know. I'm going to my car. I don't care what y'all say. Like, that's it. Shout out to iGlam. She has 50% off today. 4th of July sale. Hit her up. She has some really, really nice glasses. If you have a sale, if you have your business, you can write it in the comments right now. Shout yourself out. Like, you know, sometimes we got to do it ourselves. I'm giving y'all the platform. I feel like, you know, when you watching Versus, and like if you have a business or if you have an Instagram, you be like, follow my Instagram, you know, because you know it's so many people. I feel like even if Girl Talk have 2-3 people, always write down your business. Always say what you do, because you never know if that one person watching, when if they buy 20 glasses, 20 candles, you know what I mean? So use this, use me, like I tell y'all, you know, like write it down every day. You just never know. Follow energy, like just write it, like write your stuff, write whatever you want to say. Let's network. As y'all can see, yesterday I posted that free. She followed me on Instagram, right? I'm dumb happy. Like, I was like, oh my god. So what happened was, let me tell y'all, I'm hoping that she come on the show, so I don't know if I should save the story, but I could not sleep. Like, sometimes I can't sleep at night. So I try to do, like, you know, things that's going to help me, help my business. If I'm up, I might as well be doing something productive and not just staring at the wall like most of us do. And I do, and I still do it a lot. But, and I'm just writing. I'm texting my homegirl, Sasha. And I'm just writing different people. Like, I'm just writing people, hey, Girl Talk, da 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 da. Copying and pasting it. And I'm not even going to lie. Like, I'm not about to write this whole paragraph 10 times. And I think I wrote her, like, 6 o'clock in the morning. Like, I was up. And, like, around 4, whatever, like that, she hit me back and was like, hey, Shasha, I would love to come on the show, da 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 da. And I was like, you know? So, and I was like, you know what? I might as well go for it. Free, can you follow me? And she did, though. Like, and she did. Like, and she did. So I say, just go for it. Like, go for it. Just do it. Just do it. Like, who cares if they laugh? Who cares? Like, who cares if they say no? Who cares if they don't answer? Because you're going to get those people who do answer, who don't mind, who remember their 20s, remember when they first started. Like, you know what I mean? Like, oh, that's kind of cool. Like, people remember. Like, and some people want to. Like, I ain't doing nothing. I'm chilling. Like, I was at home with these kids anyway. I'll come on your show. You know what I mean? Like, so you don't know what, just because in your mind on, just because in your mind somebody is higher, I don't want to say higher than you, but like maybe in that profession, just, you know, further along or whatever like that. But that's just one aspect of their lives. Like, you know, we have like life, profession, personal, like head, brain, my period days. Like, each day be different. So you never know. Like, oh dang, maybe somebody haven't asked them to be on the show in a long time, or maybe somebody haven't asked them to shout out their page in a long time, and then you ask and it's like, oh shoot, they as happy as you. So, you know, just be brave, like Selena said. Like, just be brave and just do it. That's all I can say. Like, just do it. It is mad scary because, you know, everything is easier to say than to do. Like, that's a fizzy fact. But we got to do it. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it is, I'm not going to lie. Feel the fear and do it anyway. And I'm a scaredy cat. And people, and I'm shy. Like, and people be like, you're not shy. And I'm like, I really am. I really am shy. I hate meeting new people. Not like that. Not that I hate meeting them, but I just hate saying hi. Like, it's mad weird. I hate saying hi. Like, can we just know each other, or know if we're going to like each other, or know if we're going to be friends? Like, I just want to move on to the next part. And that's my problem. Like, calm down. Stop talking fast. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you just want to, like, let me just, Like, hi. Like, hey. Do we hug? And now it's COVID, right? It's COVID, you know, mask, gloves. I mean, we want it to be over, but now it's, you know. So when you're meeting people, do you hug? Do you pound? Do we shake? Like, I can't. I don't know what to do. Like, what are you comfortable with doing? Like, are we doing a salsa? Like, I don't know how to greet people now. Fist pump, right? Right. But I never fist bumped before. You know? Like, I never, like, no, I did it, but it's like, you're like, I don't know. It's kind of, it's not my thing. Like, I'd rather, like, what up? Or some people, like, I hug. I'm a hugger. Like, I met people like that. I'm a hugger. And I'm like, oh, okay. But I don't know. It's like, I met somebody. My girl introduced me to somebody the other day. And it was just kind of weird, and not because I didn't want to meet them, but because I didn't know to hug or to, yeah, I don't know what to do. So now I really don't want to meet no, like, I want to meet new people. Let me not say that, but I just want to, I want you to be my friend already. Like, like, right, skip the introduction, like, right, let's get down to business. Like, you already know. It's WBOX 1460 AM. I know everybody's hanging out. I know everybody's at the... Y'all saw that? I know everybody's hanging out. I know everybody's at the cookout. But, you know, watch the video later. Still tell a friend and tell a friend. I said no matter if it was 1, 2, 0 people watching today, that I still wanted to have a good show. Like, you know, no matter how many people was watching, or if it was just me talking to myself, I'm like, Shadness, you gotta have something. But I promise, like, I'm about to show y'all right now. I just wrote down my notes. Like, look at the time. Dang, y'all can't even see it. I'm trying to show y'all the time. 7:43. My show starts at 8:00. So I just wrote my material, which is something I don't like doing. But like I said, when I'm in my car, the thoughts just come. So I got to the station and I'm kind of, you know, I've been gray goosing. So I'm like, I'm trying to get it together. This is coffee. Well, everybody know, you know. And I wrote down all my notes, like right here. I could've been doing all my girl talk cards. And look at my handwriting. Like, I'm just radio people that's listening on the radio. I just wrote this stuff down. Look like chicken scratch. And I'm just going by it. Freestyling, you already know. Can't wait to get back to the cookout too. Like, what they doing? You know how, yo, I read the meme when it said black people don't know how to leave. It takes them 45 minutes to leave the house. Hey, all right, I'm leaving. My friend Crystal, sorry to put you on blast, Crystal. She came to visit me yesterday. She must have got there like maybe 2:30 or 3:00. This girl said she was leaving from maybe 3:30. Do you know what time she left? At 8:00 at night. But the whole time, we went through breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And the whole time, she's like, no, I'm not eating, I'm leaving. No, I'm not drinking, I'm leaving. Oh, I'm not doing this, I'm leaving. I'm like, at 6:00, we was like, girl, you still here? She was like, yeah, but I'm leaving right now. My girl didn't leave till 8:00. I was like, yo, you're that mean. Like, yeah, oh, right. Be there all day. And as a kid, it just felt really long. Like, church feels so long when you're a kid. Right. Like, wait. Like, I'm hungry. For some reason, when you go to church, you get hungry at the end. Like, you starving. Like, so what we gonna eat, though? Right? Like, are they gonna feed us? Every year, my mother swears, she doesn't remember this, but every year, we had to go down to North Carolina all summer, and I used to stay at my Aunt Doris' house. Shout out to my Aunt Doris. And we used to go to church every day. Like, so I'm in New York and we didn't go to church like that, you know what I mean? And then I go down south and it's like every day Bible study, this study, he study, we study. I'm like, can we go, like, going down south, bingo was something fun to do. Like, oh, we going to play bingo tonight. Like, I shout out to North Carolina. Shout out to Plymouth, North Carolina, where my family's from, where my family at. Shout out to Raleigh. Shout out to Cary. Shout out to Salisbury. That's where I went to college. But I used to be in Jamesville, North Carolina, and Plymouth, North Carolina, and going to bingo was exciting. Like, you know, we used to go to McDonald's with no shoes on. Like, it is country. My grandmother has, well, they had, my grandmother and grandfather had a trailer, and pigs is surrounding it. My grandfather sold pigs. So, like, there's, like, maybe, like, 300 pigs. There's a trailer, and we got a whole bunch of cars and stuff. You know, it's the country. You got all the cars broken down, this, that. Dogs everywhere, and barbed wire fence, and we had pigs. We'll go feed the pigs. Sometimes the pigs will get out. My grandfather got to go chase the pigs. But shout out to the South. But yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy. So I'm trying to read my notes right now. What we eating at the cookout? That's what I want to know. Like, so what y'all sipping on right now? Like, what's going on at the cookout? Fill me in. We inside. We got AC though. It's hot outside. This AC in here feel good. So, y'all outside. We got AC. Like, we got AC. It's hot out there. I was just out there. And the mosquitoes is out. I guess because it was raining. The mosquitoes. Like, time out. Hold on. The mosquitoes is out. But what y'all eating? Like, when I left, my mother was about to fry some fish on the grill. You take the pan, if y'all didn't know, put the oil, you can put it on top of the grill and fry your fish still, if you ain't know. But yeah, I can't wait to go eat that piece of fish, like, and some potato salad and some macaroni salad. I'm hungry. Yeah, I told my mother, all right, Ma, you know, we be like, Ma, you know, I really wanted that, so y'all better save me one. You know, mama's gonna save their kids, son. So, your mother gonna save you some food, or your mother gonna, she might whine a little bit, but your mother gonna pack you some food up or save you some food, put you side to the side. It's in the microwave, it's on top of the fridge. Where is your food hiding spots? Like, you know, when you go to your family house, I know, sorry, Sasha, I'm hungry. When you go to your family house or you go somewhere, where do you hide your plate to go? You about to order some food. Dawn, you should have came down here. Y'all should have came to my mama's backyard. Y'all know we got a backyard in the building. Yes, we live in the building. We have a really nice backyard. And my mother and my upstairs neighbor, they claim it, basically. They think they have a backyard. And I'm like, y'all, this is the building's. This is the building's backyard. Dawn, dang, you told me you was going to your friend house. You told me you was going to your friend house. You definitely could have came and chilled and ate. They got fish. They got chicken. You know, the basics. Like, they got liquor. Like, they chilling. That's what I'm about to go back to. I should have packed the plate, bro. I'm going back. I already told them. Like, y'all should have came to Cortland, like. Girl, my mother put a sign up on the back, on the door and everything. We're having a cookout. The cookout, the backyard is booked. Like, girl. But shout out to everybody listening. WVOX 1460 AM of the people. Today's episode is just about doing your thing, but not forgetting who you are. Not forgetting that you once was in your 20s. Not forgetting that one, there was a time when you did not know this was going to be your brand, or you was going to have this business, or know that you was going to be on the radio. Like, so when you see people having fun, or, you know, younger girls just, you're like, oh, why they? Because you used to do it too. You know, like, we did all of that, and that was boring. You know, like, we've been going to the club since 16. So, yes, we don't want to go to the club no more. We could just go to a lounge, but people like the club, like, you know, so I just don't want people to forget, like, the 20s, the best time of my life. But I'm sure my 30s is going to bring some greater times. But, you know, for right now, I'm only 31. 20s was great. I'm outside in these fireworks, and I'm like, yeah, it's a lot of fire. I got some fireworks in my trunk. I'm about to go back to the cookout and bust the fireworks. Like, this one. Girl, I was driving and pulled over thinking I popped my tire. You had too much. You had too much. You had too much to drink, sweetheart. So, yeah, we here. What y'all want to talk? Is there anything y'all want to say? Is there anything y'all want to do on? And Sasha, I see y'all on right now. Shout out to y'all. We both of us got some projects. Dawn is doing her thing. If you need a realtor in New Jersey, hit up Dawn Crudup. Dawn, I don't know your email, but that is her Instagram, Dawn Crudup. Crude. You know, I never really know how to say that. C-R-U-D-P-U-D. Dope. I can spell it. But yeah, she's a realtor in New Jersey. She's doing her thing. I'm proud of her. So shout out to her for doing that. Shout out to Energy and her candles and taking her cute picture all in white and stuff. I was like, you ever seen your friend do what I did that you never did? You like, I want to do that too. I want to have a photo shoot. Well, I didn't think about having a photo shoot. But shout out to you, Sai. She looked cute. You know, like, shout out to everybody doing their things. Shout out to everybody doing their thing. As you know, some people think stuff is easy. It ain't that easy. But we all out here just doing things. I was talking to Dawn. I was talking to Sasha. It's funny because I be talking to my friends about the same things. But they have different kinds of businesses. So it's like, but everybody's just been talking about just jumping out and just doing it. Like we, y'all, we got to just jump out. Like, if we don't jump out, we still going to have to be at our 9-to-5s. And nobody want to be at their 9-to-5 no more. And I love it. Like, everybody's just like, this ain't life. Like, I ain't supposed to be doing this. So, if I don't want to do this no more, I got to jump out. Like, I got to try. Like, I got to do it. I got to do it. Like, that's it. Oh, Crude Up. That's Crude Up. Oh, that's kind of cool. That's kind of cool last name. I didn't even know that. But shut up. Yeah, time to go. I almost cursed on the radio, Sasha. You almost got me in trouble. Yes, it's time to go. Everybody that I'm having a convo with is saying the same thing. It's weird. It's weird. It's weird. It's weird. But yeah, nah, like, jump out that window. Let's just do it. Like, let's just do it. Shout out to everybody. I've been making beads. I've been making, you know, beads for your stomach. I've been making anklets, waist beads, anklets. And I've been going in because it's bringing me some income. But I'm like, you know, it's like you start something and stuff just be branching. Like, you just get other ideas, and it's not always, like, the same subject, but it's something from that one. It's, like, really, you're really like a plant, like, really like a seed, and that's the... I'm doing my show, girl. Somebody text station. I didn't put my phone on, like, what does she want? I'm about to put her on blast right now, because she should know my show is on, right? She should know we on the radio, WVOX. Why you calling me? You know I'm on Girl Talk. I put you on blast. I called you off my phone. Hold on. Wait. What'd you say?
I said I thought you was in the backyard.
I was in the backyard. I had to come to work.
I forgot it was Girl Talk.
Exactly. Girl Talk.
My dad was looking for a cookout. He said to find out if y'all was doing anything.
Yeah, we in the backyard. You on Girl Talk, they can hear you on the radio.
Hey, Girl Talk.
I put the camera to the phone. To the laptop.
Stupid.
Bye, Stacia. I said she should have known I was doing Girl Talk right now.
I forgot. All right, have a good show. I love you.
Bye. All right, love you. Bye. So, yeah. Ooh. How rude. We had to put her on blast. Shout out to Johnson's BBQs. That was Stacia. Yes, she was on the show blowing my phone up. Let's play a little music. I don't know if y'all still want to hear me, but I was listening to this song that came on the radio. Like, I'm gonna hear some music. Can y'all hear it? Y'all know I be going back. I know I don't be playing 2020. My bad. But I was in the car, like,
this is how we do. We make a move and act the fool while we up in the club. This is how we do. Nobody do it like we do it, so show us some love. This is how we do. do. We make a move and act a fool while we up in the club. This is how we do. Nobody do it like we do it, so show us some love.
Fresh like, Impala, chrome hydraulics, 808 drums. You don't want none, and better run. When beef is on, I pop that drum. Come get some pistol grip pump. Give me 6 inches on them white air ones. This red rum, ready, here come.
Compton,
Drake family in the slums. Selling that skunk, one hand on my tongue. I was selling to Master P, was saying, Buck past the. It's G and the girls just wanna have fun. Coke and rum, got green on the tongue. I'm banging with my hand up a dress like, I'm making purple haze in my lungs. Whole gang in the front, kissing on the stun.
I put Lamborghini doors on that Escalade. Hey. Little pro, so don't look like I'm riding on blades. In 1 year, man, you know I'm so great. I have a straight chick in the telly going both ways. Touch me, tease me, kiss me, please me. I give it to you just how you like it, girl. Hey. You're now rocking with the best set thing on my hip. Teflon on my chest. They say I'm no good, cause I'm so hood. Rich folks do not
this
want
part,
me
this part.
Cause it might pop off, but when it pop part. Off, somebody gon' get laid the f*** out. They this call me new money, say I have no class. I'm from no bottom, I came up too fast. The hell if I care, I'm just here to get my cash. They boost me, I'm hood, they kiss my
what?
This is how we do.
Right.
We make a move and act the fool while we up in the club.
Right.
This is how we do. Nobody do it like we do it, so show us some love. This is how we do.
Like,
we
make a move and act
the fool while we up in the club. This is how we do.
Sometimes
nobody do it like we do it, so show us some love.
Gold Daytonas on that cherry 6-4. White wall so clean like I'm riding on boats. Hit one switch, man. That cherry so low. Cali got hood to New York, ride, know how to scroll. Touch me, tease me, kiss me, please me. I give it to you just how you like it, girl. You're now rocking with the best. Saw chrome on my hip, Teflon on my chest. 50, Bentley, MK, man, got a fresh out the slum. Automatic, never one-on-one. We're at Pumpkin Pump, it's done, you're done. Homie, it's game time. You ready? Here come. Call Lloyd Banks
to get some.
Crunk, it took 2 months, but 50 got it done. Signed with G on it, had the hood like, huh? Don't try to front, I'll leave your slump. Thinking I'm a punk, get your homie's head lump. 50 got a, ready, here it comes. Got a sick vendetta to get this. Tryna be my book, better the drama. Said I sip on more, better my flow sounds. Better than average, your tracks, I'm a savage.
I wasn't even reading
anybody
my comments.
On my clip.
G, you like, we had to throw some music under here. Like, we had to throw a little bit. That's what I was listening to. That's what I was blasting when I came in. I was like, oh, okay. Yeah. I came up from the bottom too fast. Like, all right, ain't that too fast? I know, but then the people on Girl Talk can't hear it. Yeah. That's the only thing. That's what's messing it up. I don't know if I should just start going straight from the radio and making people just listen to me on the radio. What do y'all think? Do y'all like being able to see me and talk to me? Or do y'all think I should just do a straight radio? How y'all feel? I really don't want to do a straight radio. So Maxine sent a request. Yeah, me too. You know, I have that situation with my job where I was totally violated. And people just keep talking to me about Girl Talk and how you sure you want to do it and it might mess up your case. And I'm just like, I feel like Girl Talk is, this is meant for me to do. Like, you know what I mean? And my situation at work don't have nothing to do what I do here. Like, who knows? You know, it's something with anxiety. But how they didn't know before I came here, I had to pop a Xanax to calm me down because, you know what I mean? I had a thought. Like, so, funny thing, I was just talking to my aunt before I came here. Shout out to my aunt Missy. I have 8 aunts. Rest in peace, Aunt Goldie. But she was just like, Shawty's, like, you gotta do what makes you happy. She was like, do what makes you happy. And I was like, you're right. You know what I mean? Like, right, what makes you happy? Like, you gotta do what makes you happy, even though other things may be going on in your life. And right, definitely when it makes a difference in somebody else's life. Like, and you helping somebody can help you. You know what I mean? It's just weird. It's just that I feel like there's always something. Like, even I think you could be a trillionaire, and it's just always gonna be something. Like, it's weird, you know? Like, people think money, no problems, but more money, more problems, that's what they say. And it's like, dang, are they right? You know what I mean? But it's like, I guess it's the way that you deal with it and how you get through it, you know? And if I feel like if you're really not doing the wrong thing, you're going to be good. Like, God's going to have your back. It might be a little funny, a little weird, but you ain't doing nothing wrong, you know? And I don't know. Like, it's just, you know, I don't know. Right. You never know until you try. Right. Like, nothing. Because, right. Because what happened? Right. Like, what? Like, I don't know. It's just that when people talk about girls, like, I ain't got no kids, so girl talk is my baby, besides my nieces, y'all know. You know, Carly Riley, shout out to y'all. But, I don't know. Like, I don't like when people try to tell me what to do either. Especially when it's, like, a situation that has nothing to do with another situation. But it kind of makes you paranoid because it's in your ear, you know? And I read this book. It's called Conversations with God. And it's about a guy who was going through something. I think his girlfriend cheated on him. And he wrote down the paper, like, when he'd get mad, he'd write questions to God. Like, God, why did you make this happen? Or, God, why did you do that to me? And one day he wrote back. The book is very interesting, I would say. It's not like a religious book or something like that, but it just makes things kind of, like, you start to understand things a little bit. And I think when you're in different places in life and you read the book, you get a different message. So Conversations with God, I forgot the author, but Google that. And, you know, if y'all decide to read it, let me know what you think. Like, let me know what you think about it. Conversations with God. But yeah. But in the book, I always remember it said, go with your first thought. Right? And that always stuck with me. Because it's like, you know, when you didn't go with that first thought and somebody said something to you. And then you changed your mind. And then you be like, yo, I knew I should never done that. Should have went with that first thought. They said the second thought is the thought that people put in your brain. Like, you know, you when it first happened, this is what you thought to do. But then you might have called your homegirl, called your mom. It don't matter who it is. Or, you know, you call somebody and it's like, girl, oh no. And you're like, oh yeah, maybe I should do that then. Go with that first thought. I feel like doing that, like, the times that I didn't do it and I said to myself, Shanice, go with your first thought, go with your first thought. And I still went against it. It was wrong. Like, it was wrong. All the time is weird. So, everybody, go with your first thought. Go with your first thought. You know, the first positive thought. You know, the first positive thought. Go with that. Do that. I don't know. Do that. Shout out to my waist bees. Like I was saying, we starting the waist bee challenge tomorrow. We getting fit. It's about 7-8 of us. I'm going to start the group chat right after this. If you're in the waist bead challenge and you're here, put your hand up. Shout out to y'all. We're starting this new thing. This is something that came to me in my car. It came to me in my car. And I was like, actually with the waist bead, Selena put that idea in my head. But the waist bead challenge, I'm like, we could do something with this. And I'm getting chunky. Like, I am getting chunky, like, oh my God, I be seeing myself in pictures, like, I am going to lie to y'all, like, Shanice, when you blow up, you need to be looking good, like, you know what I mean? You ain't going to be in the shade room, like, you going to be looking good, like, I need to be stacked, like, so, it's like, I know where I want to be, right? And you know TV add on 15 pounds or whatever like that, I can't afford that. So, Shanice, you know that something's about to pop off. You can feel it in your body, right? You feel it in your body. That's what your thoughts is telling you. You need to be prepared, sis, right? So the hair is, y'all don't even want me to take the hair out. but let's get the body together so when it do come, they're like, oh yeah, you ready. Like, and it shouldn't go off your body, but for me and my mind, I just want to be a certain way. I want to be a certain weight. Like, sis is like 300 pounds. I don't feel like it. And that's no, like, I'm not trying to diss nobody. If that's, you know, how you look, that's how you are, that's fine. I'm talking about me. I'm talking about me when I sit down and my stomach is on my lap. Like, I don't like it. Like, that wasn't me in my 20s now. Like, no, Shanice. I don't care what y'all say about that relationship weight. No, no, it's not. I don't want it. Right? I don't like the way it feel for me. For me. And we're starting the waist speed challenge. Waist speed challenge start tomorrow. A bunch of girls, guys don't wear waist speeds, so not that they can't, you know, you gotta be like correct. Not that they can, but it's a bunch of it's a few girls. We're gonna be in the group chat together, and I've been thinking of different ideas to push each other. Everybody's gonna write something tomorrow. I want everybody to send a picture of their waist speeds, their stomach on their waist speeds, and if they could, like, take a picture of them on a scale or something like that, just so we can have a record. It don't have to be your face or nothing like that. Just take a picture. And the goal is to get the waist speeds to your hips. So I've been making the waist speeds. People have been telling me their size. I ask everybody for their number, or I take their number. So I actually have a record of everybody's, like, stomach size. And at the end, we're going to see, I feel like we should do it for a month. Because when you try to do things for too long, 2 months, 5 months, it's not that interesting anymore. Like, you know what I mean? So we got to do this slowly. And maybe each month we'll have a new challenge. A new challenge, a new, like, weight loss idea. Weight Beast Challenge was just something I thought of. I never really heard of a Weight Beast Challenge. So, you know, I was in my car gave me my thoughts. And I'm like, waist speed challenge, like, that just sounds cool. Like, and to actually, you know, sometimes when you're working out, you're like, I ain't losing weight. And somebody be like, girl, yes, look at your neck. You be like, uh-uh, my neck been like that. With the waist beads, if you know where the waist beads at. And once you start going, seeing them go down on your stomach and get to your hips, you know what I mean? It's just a way that we're going to keep record. And if somebody else want to try this challenge, you can. If you don't want to be in a group chat, that's fine. Use the idea. To me, it's not that serious. Like, you know, I want people to be healthy. So, waist beads challenge. Waist beads challenge. But yeah, we here. You know that feeling when you're about to sneeze? That's it right now. But yeah, WVOX 1460 AM, the voice of the people. Girl talk, we here, we lit. I was at the cookout just like y'all, and I'm looking like, oh, it's getting dark. Is the cookout still gonna be going on? So I hope you guys are enjoying yourselves. People who had to order out and stuff like that, I hope you're enjoying your family. I hope you're enjoying yourself. I hope you're enjoying the TV, whatever you're doing. If you watch your Family Feud, that's my show. Do it. Let me look at my notes. So I told you I wrote down a whole bunch of notes before I got here. Okay, I got songs I was supposed to play, but I was just talking a mile a minute. Look, it says, talk about 20s, about always not being like this, not always being mature. I'm not even all the way that mature, but I'm just more mature than I was. I also have more, like, I never thought in a million years that I'll have anxiety. Like, let's be for real. Like, having anxiety is mad weird because, I mean, I guess if you didn't have it, like, none of your life, and then all of a sudden you got, like, anxiety, and you hear about it on, like, TV or something like that, or you hear somebody say, I got anxiety. And I feel like I used to say that, like, in high school. You giving me anxiety, but you really don't know what that is until you experience it. And now that I experience it, I'm like, this is not a great feeling. Like, this is really weird that this can happen to your body. Like, it's weird. And I don't wish this on nobody. Like, just for your heart to start beating dumb fast and you losing your thoughts. And, like, that is super weird. Like, I don't wish that, like, on, I don't want it. Like, I don't want it. I don't want it. So, you know, with this happening, I try to find things to do. Making beads has been helping me because I'm busy. Shout out to y'all for ordering. The orders are coming in. Like, ooh, the orders is coming in. But yes, though, mental health is serious. Like, it really is. And now, I don't know. Most times when people do crazy things, I'm like, yo, that might be a mental health. Like, now that I'm going through, I'm like, that might be mental health. Like, or that might be mental health. Busy and quiet. Just, let me tell y'all something about Selena. She acts like I get on her nerve. I'm talking too much. I'm on her. I won't let her breathe. You know, sometimes I do want to be part of her skin. Like, I want to be, I want to go everywhere you go. But when I'm doing my beads, I'm like quiet. I'm doing my thing. And she's like, you so quiet when you do those beads. Like, oh, now you want me to mess with you. Shout out to my boo. I missed you. But we here. Y'all already know. Girl talk. Order your beads. DM me. Do whatever you have to do. We're also making anklets. And I think I'm about to start making earrings. Now, I know most like, you know, it's like it'll be the earrings too. But I think I can make it with like crystals and stuff like that. I'm about to start experimenting. This is, you know, income made. So, you know, I'm just finding different ways to deal with what I'm going through, to manage girl talk, to manage personal life. Everything is not easy. And like I always told y'all, tell y'all, like, be nice to people. Cause you really don't know what people be going through. Like, you would have no idea, oh, she look cute, her makeup is this, or she, you know, but you just never know what's in somebody's head. Like, you know what I mean? Especially if they don't show it. Or if they used to it so they know how to hide it, you know? It's crazy. It really is. Like, so be nice to people. And that's it. Like, be nice, you know? You could say good morning. Just be mean. No, you never know what I'm like going through. Like, don't do that. But yeah, so we here on Girl Talk, WVOX, 1460 AM, The Voice of the People. I think I talk about all my subjects, waist beat challenges. Yeah, challenges that people can create. Create things, like, it just, I don't know, it helps. Like, for the waist beat challenge, I'm going to tell y'all, I have an idea of me and my girl and her daughter, we was doing twerk workouts. And I was really trying, but the workout, I was really tired too. Like, whoa, time out. But it was something fun. And I just randomly like Googled it, being me, just being silly. And now I'm like, that's how ideas come to me. Like, okay, so my waist beat challenge, I could tell them like, all right, 8 o'clock, y'all, let's do this workout. Whoever's not doing nothing, if you ain't get to work out today, if you home, like, let's just do it. It's fun. We do, like, you know, and it's together. So I know I keep hitting the table too. But, you know, it's just something to do and a way to get healthy. Like, we got to be here. I want to say shout out to all the pop-up shops. I think pop-up shops is the best thing. I've done one and it was really nice and I didn't want to do it. I really didn't want to sell my clothes and stuff like that in a pop-up shop because I didn't think it would sell. And I sold a lot of shirts, surprisingly, to me. So shout out to all the pop-up shops. Shout out to people doing it. I feel like that's a way to network. It's a way to meet new people, to get a new crowd. I think pop-up shops is bomb. I think that people should travel and do pop-up shops. Like, if you can on the weekends or whatever you offer, something like that, do a pop-up shop in Philly. Like, if you, because when you in your city and you're doing pop-up shops, I'm sure you meet other people that's, you know, other brands that's at the pop-up shops. Like Mount Vernon. If you do Mount Vernon ones, you're going to keep seeing the Mount Vernon people. So if you want to go to a different state, oh, you do this, you do that, you do that. Girl, let's all go together. You know, because when you go to different places, you know, sometimes you should have people with you. Let's all three go. It's a pop-up shop in Jersey or Pennsylvania, something like that. And let's just all go together. Like, you know what I mean? Let's all go together and just visit different states. everybody's doing it. It's just a way to sell your stuff. Like, that's an idea I had. I feel like for the waist beads, I'm going to start doing pop-up shops. Why not? Let's see what happens. Waist beads to me is not something that I see everybody doing all the time. Not saying that, you know, if you do stuff, if you're doing something that people do, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying for me. I don't really want to, I'll have Girl Talk shirts and Girl Talk stuff and talk about Girl Talk and also me travel. Oh, I need to take my own advice because me traveling to different states, different pop-up shops, I could give out my business card and have more guests on Girl Talk and promote more businesses and network with more people. So you see what I mean? So sometimes you just got to talk it out loud, like just talk it to yourself and then things start making sense. So I know three friends that has their own businesses. Now I need to take my own advice, y'all. Let's go to this place. Let's go to that place. Let's go to this place. You know, why not? Why can't you? I feel like if you really want something to pop off, like with pop-up shops, like it's the way. It's the connect. You don't know who somebody's cousin, who might be coming, who somebody's boyfriend. Like, you know, you don't know. So let's do pop-up shops. And I'm also always taking donations and things like that. You know, we pay for the show every Sunday to come on here. Nothing's free. So if you ever want to donate, if you ever want to do anything, my Cash App is Girl Talk. I see that sometimes people won't respond to me once I tell them that there's a fee to come on. But I'm also running a business also, and I have to. You know, if you're selling shirts or something, whatever, and it's $50 and I say donations $100, that's only two shirts you had to sell. I guess because I am giving them something. I'm giving them airtime, I'm giving them radio, Instagram, YouTube. And I guess since people can't hold it, sometimes if we can't hold it or feel it, we feel like it's not like something, you know what I mean? So I guess with the radio station, people want to come on, but if I say a donation, it's like, why? You know, like, it's not like I'm not asking you to buy a candle, but I'm still giving you something also. You know, you're not just throwing your money in the air. But yes, we have what, 5 minutes left, guys. This was fast. I hope y'all enjoyed. I hope we covered everything. I hope that somebody got something out of this. I hope somebody's eating some good food right now. Just made them a good drink. Put a little lemon in it. I know I keep saying we all got things to get better at. But yeah, shout out to y'all. Shout out for the people for listening today. And whenever you listen. And it's okay if you can't listen every Sunday. People have things to do. And I understand that. But just tell a friend to tell a friend. Like, you know, if you have a convo and, oh, Girl Talk, that's it. That's all I need. And I could do the rest, you know. I could do my talking. But tell a friend to tell a friend. That's all we ask. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Tell a friend. That's it. You know, that's the least. That's the least we ask for. Not the least, that's the most we ask for, right? What is it? Sorry, look at my eyes. Whatever is the correct way to say it, that's what I mean. Like, you know, whatever you could do, you could do. I want to go out to a song. Which I want to hear. I want to hear this song. Oh, I want to hear this song, I think. Y'all, I love y'all. Thank y'all for tuning in. I want to hear this song.
Fresh spies everywhere,
hiding in plain
sight. Y'all
know what? Oh, that's ghetto. I've been ghetto right now, y'all. Shout out to everybody listening to on the radio, WVOX 1460 AM, the voice of the people. I love y'all. Shout out to y'all. Shout out to everybody for listening. Let's go out to this right here. And it's the video. I'm trying to be cool.
Smile.
style. Shake just a little bit faster. Shake just a little now, girl. Dying to meet you, so let's mess around. Got an obsession with us getting down. Come just a little bit closer. I just need permission, so
give me
Look at me in Disney.
No competition, no other.
I can't do it because I can't see my face.
I got a feeling winning this race. Baby, I'm getting much closer. I just need permission. So
this is what gets me down to the y'all. I love y'all. Shout out to listening. Love y'all. Bye-bye.